So this is so we're going to talk today about Alzheimer's disease. We're going to talk about getting drugs into the brain. I'm John Finke. I'm in SIIS. And here's a bunch of my stats. I was told, I guess we needed to have these. All I can say is that I went to school for a long time, longer than I should have. And, you know, now I'm on the academic gravy train here at UWT. So we'll just go to the next. Go ahead and hit it. So we're going to talk a little bit about the blood-brain barrier, but I'd like to talk about two other famous barriers. Quick, we're on speed round. Where are we over here? Troy, where are we over here? Death Star. Excellent, excellent. Your pop culture and history is great. Okay, so what do these two barriers have in common with the blood-brain barrier? They don't let things in? Anything else? What about those two stories? What's happening in those two stories?
Deception.
Infiltrating? What's behind the barrier?
Danger.
Also, something that needs to come out. Right, something needs to be rescued. All right, so moving on into Alzheimer's disease. Whoa, we're moving fast. So it's a loss of memory and language, but that occurs in a lot of different conditions. The histopathology that is consistent with Alzheimer's disease is actually certain regions of the brain that are smaller, and they have these plaques that have formed, and that's the actual definition postmortem. So why should you care? Well. This is our society is aging. We are expecting, think about the number 3, a tripling of the number of people in our population, the percentage, and also of the costs as a percentage of healthcare. Okay, so what about drugs? Thumbs down. That's my quick definition of that. Basically, you got like a 99.8% failure rate. There's actually no curative drugs as compared to cancer, which is like 80% failure rate. Okay, so a popular drug target that they're trying to get at is the beta amyloid protein, which is the protein that is making up these plaques that are found in the brain. So there's a big emphasis on trying to get those out of the brain. And a way to do that is in antibodies. So they're trying to design, you know, this immunotherapy where there's antibodies that are designed to go in and target these plaques. And antibodies are great. They do two things very well. They target just one thing, and they also recruit the body's natural immune system to get whatever it is out of there. The big problem is the brain doesn't want antibodies in the brain. The blood-brain barrier keeps it out. It's estimated that 0.1%, so 1 in 1,000 of the antibodies that you inject into the brain actually get to even there in the first place. So our research is trying to figure out whether we can take a hint from viruses. And so HIV is a virus that has these sugars on it. And if you take those sugars out, the HIV virus cannot get into the brain. And so we're interested in adding a particular sugar to this antibody. Go ahead and click it. It's called sialic acid that we think might help antibodies, therapeutic antibodies, get into the brain and actually do something. So go ahead and go to the next slide. All right, so how do you get people to go places they don't want to be? And I think used car sales are an excellent example of this. It was Kurt Russell, Used Cars, Robert Zemeckis film back from 1980. I'm sure we've all seen it. So there's two strategies. One is to increase the flow in, and you do that by making giant balloon animals of Godzilla or little floppy guys flying in the wind. Or you sweet talk the customers and keep them from getting out. Okay, so you increase the flow in to where you're trying to get, or you decrease the flow back out. All right, so what are the results of this? So we have our antibody. It's in the blood side of the experiment. And we want to ask the question, what happens when we add the sialic acid? So go ahead, Lisa. No effect. Shucks. I guess we could have just, you know, packed up our things and gone home. But there was this other way that we wanted to investigate is whether or not the sialic acid had an effect on the efflux or the actual outflow from the brain back to the blood. So go ahead and click that one. So here's our experiment. We also put the antibody on the other side, on the brain side of the barrier, and asked whether the sialic acid would affect that. So go ahead and click that. And in that case, it actually shut it down almost like 90%. So it was a huge, so this is actually pretty exciting. The sialic acid did have this effect of actually keeping the antibodies in the brain and keeping them from going back out. But that actually wasn't the most exciting thing we found. Go ahead. It actually had this weird effect where it was affecting other antibodies. So the whole system of efflux of antibodies was being shut down. And we actually think that this might actually have some applications that go beyond Alzheimer's disease for like, you know, glioblastoma or brain cancer or other conditions. So go ahead and just hit the last slide. Well, there was a little slide that said, talked about future directions. What, find out more about this, why this happens, and also design some non-antibody molecules that might have the same effect. We're done. Thanks. We used a model system. We used what's called a transwell, which is a little cup where the actual endothelial cells from the brain are placed. And you can shoot, they orient themselves the way they do in the brain. And so you can put the antibodies on one side or the other of the experiment. So, all right. Thank you.